give honor to all the preachers, pastors that are gathered in this place on this afternoon. We thank God for changing Partners Temple of Refuge Ministries. We thank God for the vision that this pastor has for this ministry. We thank God for your hospitality. We thank God for how you have received us on this afternoon. And we count it an honor and a privilege to stand before you on today. So good to see also Minister Sutton. God bless you, sir. You make me feel like I'm somebody's preacher. I go on Facebook and you got my stuff all over your page. With us on this morning. So I thank you, sir. I honor you and I praise God. Praise God for you. Amen. Amen. I thank God also for our apostolic advocate, Minister Reeves, and our pastor of evangelism, Elder Freeman. We thank God for his presence. We thank God for how they always support us and go with us where we need them to go. And we thank God. Thank God for that. And I thank God for all of you who is here on this morning. You could be anywhere else, but you're here. And we thank God. We thank God for it. There's the word from the Lord.
Yes, it is.
Just wanted to wait for Pastor and the others to come back out. Amen. To be with us. Genesis chapter 50. Genesis chapter 50. Genesis chapter 50. Amen. Genesis chapter 50. You don't have to go too far. Very first book of the Torah. Very first book of the Pentateuch. One of the five books that were written by God's man by the name of Moses. Genesis chapter 50. I want to read verses 18 through 21. Genesis chapter 50. Verses 18 through 21. But you haven't said, I got the word.
I got the word.
Amen. 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 And the word of God reads this thus. And his brethren also went and fell down before his face. And they said, behold, we be thy servants. And Joseph said unto them, fear not, for I am in the place. Am I in the place of God? But as for you, ye thought evil against me, but God meant it unto good.
Well,
to bring to pass, as it is this day, to save much people alive. Now therefore, fear ye not, I will nourish you and your little ones. And he comforted them and spake kindly unto them. I want to stress on verse 20 that says, but as for you, ye thought evil against me, but God meant it unto good. To bring to pass, as it is this day, to save much people alive. I want to talk about this afternoon, but God. Look at your neighbor real good and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
But God.
But God.
I need somebody to say it like you really mean it. A brother preach here this morning. Look at your neighbor again and say, neighbor.
Neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
Oh, neighbor.
But God.
But God.
For the assurance that God has everything and your neighbor and say, be well assured.
Be well assured.
That God, has everything, under control. I know it looks crazy. Yeah. I know it looks a mess. Yeah. I know it looks confusing. But God has everything under control. Uh-huh. And we must all understand, my brothers and sisters, that what the enemy is doing in our midst is what he is supposed to do.
Well,
but it will never take control from God. I don't think you heard what I'm saying. Everything that the enemy is doing, he is supposed to do.
Amen.
But that does not take away the control from God. Look at your neighbor and say, God still has it under control.
God still has it under control.
Because listen, every move that Satan makes, he has to get permission from God in order to make it. God is so in control. Listen to this. Do you know that God created Lucifer?
Well,
he did not create his ways, but he created him. Come on, talk to me here. Lucifer was an angel in glory. He was in charge of the music ministry in glory. But he got a little beside himself.
Come on, now.
I might even be saying this. And so many problems with musicians.
Well,
we don't know whether they're straight or not. Come on, we
got to talk
about it. It's because the enemy came out of the music ministry. And Lucifer used to be an angel of light. But he got beside himself, and the Lord put him out of heaven.
Right.
And Lucifer began to do his work here on earth. Against us. But what God does is he takes
That's it. Yes, sir.
God help me. Hey, I'm like limousine. Yes. I don't know how long, but if the limousine pulls up at my house and they say, I'm going to take you somewhere, I bet you need to go. I'm getting in the limousine. Because there's nothing like being driven.
That's it.
Turns around and flips. never knew. But God experience will give you a testimony about what God can do. But God experience will give you evidence that God's word is true. Look at your neighbor and say, I gotta have a what God experience. Look at your neighbor again and say, I gotta have a what God experience. Glory to God, I would be right there. Look at your neighbor again and say, I gotta have a what God experience. See, I gotta have a what God experience because the word says that he will deliver us of many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord will deliver us out of them all. If I don't have an affliction, then I can't experience the word.
That's right.
See, it's good for me to read this word and be shouting on this word, but it's better for me to have an experience with the word.
Go ahead.
In other words, you can't believe that God is Jehovah Jireh until you have nothing.
That's it.
What does Jehovah Jireh mean? Jehovah Jireh means that God will provide. So you have to be without in order to experience God being Jehovah Jireh. You didn't catch it. You got to be sick in order to experience God being Jehovah Rapha. Which means the God that heals all manner of sickness. How can you know that he heals if you've never been sick? So you've got to go through experiences in order to experience what I call a what God experience. Look at your neighbor and say, what God. A what God experience will cause you to bless somebody else. A what God experience will remove some things from your life that will hinder you from running this race. Every child of God will have a but God experience.
Amen.
I don't care if you wear a collar, if you got a cross around your neck, a gooey on your head, and you got all these titles in front of your name, you are going to have a but God experience.
Yes, sir.
I don't care if you know the Bible from Genesis to Revelation.
Hello.
And you speak in tongues every day of your life.
Uh-huh.
You're going to have a but God experience. What I'm trying to get y'all to do is change your attitude about your experience.
That's it.
Instead of complaining about your experience, you ought to shout and dance in your experience.
Yeah.
You ought to give God glory in your experience.
Uh-huh.
God, I need somebody real quick to say, God's getting ready to give me another kind of praise. As long as things are going our way, I mean, we got a real good praise. But God is looking for a good praise when you're broke. When you don't know what next thing is going to happen, when you don't know how they're going to make it, when you don't know how things are going to turn out. It says, to save much people alive. Okay. Yeah, don't say that. Okay. I gotta break it down. You must be catching. Joseph had to go through all of those experiences so that God can put him in position to save his family. I want you to know right now that what you're going through is all a part of God's plan to bring you to a place to help somebody else.
Amen.
Experience. When he was in the lion's for what I'm going through.
My Lord.
Because what I'm going through is just a setup for me to be ready for what God is about to do in my life.
My God.
Joseph said, what you thought was going to be evil, what you thought was going to take me out, was really just a setup to save much people alive.
Amen.
I'm glad for what God experienced. So if you're going through something right now, hey boo, stop crying. Stop. Stop fussing. Stop. Stop having your pity party. Matter of fact, pop the balloons.
I know that's right.
Cake back in the refrigerator.
Yeah.
Tear up the invitation for your pity party. It is over.
Yes.
God is about to show up.
Show up.
And show up. In your life. I'm going to say it in the words of my cousin, Bishop J. Delano Ellis, Cleveland, Ohio. He said, God, stomp your feet in this place.
Jesus.
It's a change. In the name of Jesus. I ain't going to worry about this situation, Lord. Because God, you get ready to turn this situation. My wife says it all the time. God is about to do a 360-degree turn in your life. You're about to experience
Jesus.
Oh God.